Hey there, my name is Val and I share content creation tips for creators to make engaging and cinematic content. And one thing that can instantly level up your YouTube videos is your intro. The first few seconds of your video really sets the stage for your audience to understand who you are and what type of content you create. But you may be thinking, Val, creating professional looking intros takes hours, especially if you're creating them from scratch. Well, you are in luck because today I will be showing you how to search, preview, and license templates with the Adobe Stock panel directly inside Adobe Premiere to create beautiful cinematic intros and lower thirds in seconds. By the way, if you're not familiar, Adobe Stock has thousands of motion graphic templates that you can use directly inside Premiere. And this literally saves me hours instead of having to build things like intros from scratch. And with the new Adobe Stock panel, I can do everything inside Premiere without having to switch tabs and really mess up that creative flow when you're editing. Let's get started and work on our video. Inside Premiere, you're going to open up the new Adobe Stock panel. Once you open Adobe Premiere, you go to the window and then click Adobe Stock. Here's what it looks like. In the search bar, you can use keywords to narrow down your search. You can also click on this filter option and choose filters like horizontal, vertical format videos, panoramic square, and also the duration of your video can be adjusted if you need these settings. I'm going to type in a title. And here I'm going to choose one that matches my aesthetic. I'm going for that typewriter retro vintage vibe for my intro. And here I'm going to just search, and you can do the same. Once you decide which type of title you like, go ahead and click on the download button. And here you're going to license that asset and bring it to your project. So I chose this retro computer typing effect for our video, and I already dragged it inside our project. I love that I can do all of this inside Premiere without having to open an Adobe Stock window or switch between tabs. No interruptions, it's just me getting to my final edit faster inside Premiere. It's pretty much full creative freedom without any limits. And this saves me so much time and allows me to focus on being a creator and on my creative process instead of spending hours sourcing and editing assets. Now let's get back to our title. Here, we're going to go ahead and start with doing some adjustments. Go to your properties panel right here, and here under text controls, you can change the actual text to whatever you need, and our text automatically changes inside our video, as you can see. One of my signature moves is making my text yellow. This just creates a really nice cinematic vibe to my videos, and it's also very bright and stands out. So go ahead and click on the color option here. I'm gonna find the yellow that I prefer, more of like a warm yellow color, and we're going to go ahead and click OK, and automatically our text turns the color that we want. Under effect controls, we can also control the amount of noise we want. I don't want too much noise, so I will reduce it to around 34. And also we can adjust the text glow. I'm also going to reduce that to 44. Under transform, we can change the position of our text. So I'm going to go ahead and bring it down by pushing that position down. For our last adjustments, go ahead and go to our opacity right here and click on screen. This way we have also a beautiful effect on the text as well. Next, one of my favorite tricks is to add a transition in between my clips. And Adobe Stock has amazing transitions that you can easily source, preview, and license and add to your timeline without ever having to leave Premiere. You can literally browse millions of stock transition templates and assets like film burns, light streaks, and glitch effects. Inside the search panel, go ahead and search light streak transition. After you choose and license your transition, go ahead and add it to your project like this. Here, I'm going to find the part of the light streaks that I like the most, and I'm going to go ahead and cut it for that section to be visible only. Once you have cut the transition, go ahead and grab it and place it approximately in the same area of the transition of the two clips. Next, we're going to go ahead and click on the opacity and click on screen. And now we have a beautiful transition. It's very cinematic, it's very vintage, and the only thing that we're missing is audio tracks. And this is one of my pro tips. Adding audio tracks and whoosh sounds from Adobe Stock makes your video so much more cinematic, and your video will just feel so much more polished. So let's get started. Go to your audio section inside our Adobe Stock panel. And inside the search bar, we're going to search for whoosh sound. And I'm going to go ahead and listen to them and see which ones I want to download and license. Next, we're going to place our audio track in the middle of these two clips. So we have that beautiful transition and audio track in the back. And next, we're gonna do another audio track. So go ahead and search typing. Once you've added the keyboard audio track, go ahead and cut it. And I'm gonna cut it to the section where our text stops typing. Finally, let's export and see the end result. Here's how our cinematic Adobe Stock intro turned out. Now let's compare if we didn't use Adobe Stock assets. Do you see the difference? One feels basic and the other feels like a polished professional intro. So if you want your YouTube videos to look cinematic and professional without spending hours designing, try the new Adobe Stock panel in Adobe Premiere to help you create and edit stunning intros with Adobe Stock assets. They're easy, they're customizable, and they help you focus on what's really important, which is creating. So check out Adobe Stock within the Adobe Stock panel inside Adobe Premiere in your next project. And for more content and video tips, like this video and subscribe to Adobe Creative Cloud.